Hi, and welcome back to my channel. This is part 3 to the Church Birdhouse series. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to add details to the roof, create the steeple, and then make sure you get in your stonework and your brickwork details. Hello to any of the new subscribers. Any questions? You know the drill down below. Thanks so much for watching, and as always, have fun with it. The first thing you're going to want to do is go around the church windows where the foam pieces are and add in lines so you get a brickwork detail. I did some variety in terms of spacing because then it gave it more of a keystone look and bricks as well. So that's the first thing you want to do. And the next thing you're going to do is move down to the bump outs and add in a stone look. And this is where you put in different sizes, different shapes, and I use a sharp pencil first to do all of this. And you want to make sure you get the side angles too, because those can kind of hide on you until you realize as you're turning it around that you need to bring the lines around again to make it really look like brick or stones. After you've gone through using your sharp pencil, go back with a ballpoint pen, preferably in black. This is going to help you deepen the grooves. It's also going to help when you have to do a darker wash on the church. Here's another side of it, and there's the back. Now for the roof. The roof is actually pretty easy, but first you're going to want to cut out these pieces of 2 inches long by a half inch wide. To get started, you're going to take one of those pieces and put them at the very peak of the roof. That's going to act again as a keystone for you. And as you can see, I have it plotted down along one side of the roof here. You want to get into line up, and actually that upper right hand corner lies nicely against the top of the roof edge. So use that as a guide for yourself. Once you have them on with hot glue and it's cooled, you're then going to want to take your X-Acto knife or a knife like that and trim away the excess on the bottom. So you're going to follow that line of the wood of the roof and use that to guide you down as you cut off those extra pieces. So there's one side trimmed up. What you do to one side, you definitely want to make sure you do to the other. And then once you have both sides trimmed up and completed, there's some finishing details you're going to add. First thing is you're going to take wooden coffee stirrers and put them with hot glue underneath the foam edge, because now it's sort of brought out the bottom of the roof. Once you get that on, you're going to put more of those stirrers up on the front of the facade of the roof. This is more for an interest visual architectural deal. And when that's all taken care of, you're going to place a strip of foam along that edge, just because that looks very rough now with everything else getting capped and added some extra details. So it's just a strip of foam cut to the overall length of the roof now, and it's going to be about the width of half an inch. And when you get that cut to size, you're going to use hot glue and put it right where that edge is. And you see it gives it a better finish once it's on. The next thing I did was I took some jewelry findings that I have, and these are barrel-shaped beads that I have in my stash. And I just put one of those at the end of each stirrer, and it gives each roof corner a nice little cap ending. And because it has those edging in it, it's also pretty cool when it gets painted up. So here's what the roof looks like done. Now we're going to go on to the steeple. For the steeple, you want to get the foam wrapped around the base of the steeple. And yes, you do want to make sure you're mitering edges just so it has a nice seamless blend from steeple into the roof. I also did add a filigree round at the peak of each roof where the coffee stirrers are, just again, more architectural interest. And as you work your way around the steeple, you want to make sure you start with the two outer sides, and then I went in and worked the sides that had more of the angle that you're going to have to cut. When it's all together, it's going to end up looking something like that. And I have a couple other views for you. And then you're going to move on to adding in brick details for the steeple as well. You don't want to leave it flat. So this, it was the same thing, sharp pencil and back with a ballpoint pen to deepen the grooves. Next thing is the top of the steeple. And yes, this is a Dollar Tree plastic trophy. You can find these guys where they keep the goodie bag items. Sometimes they're on end caps, but just keep your eye out for them. This fits perfectly over that triangle. So once you get it on with hot glue, you're also going to want to make sure you cut off that bottom part of the trophy, but leave a stump. You want to keep that stump. And once the hot glue is cooled, you're going to put on a pencil eraser. Believe it or not, it creates the perfect top for the steeple. That you need to attach with super glue. Again, let that dry completely before you do anything with that. Now we're going to texture all of those details. So with the roof, take a wire brush or a steel brush, something along those lines, and just pull it from top to bottom along those shingles, and it starts creating those grooves. Then you can take a brush as well and kind of go through and stipple on the stonework. You can take a rolled up ball of foil. I actually have some old pieces of coral that I'll use, believe it or not. And this is what's going to give the stone more of that stone-like appearance when it comes time to paint it up. So this is pretty much set and ready to go. So what I did now is put on that first layer of paint so it would be ready for when I actually start going and painting and everything. For this mix that I did, it is Mod Podge with half black, half dark brown mixed in with each other. And this way, you don't get a true pure black. It's gonna let some depth be added into the stonework right away. So I put that on every little bit of the church except for those four filigree rounds at the top of the steeple. And this is the point I'm at right now. I will get around to getting this painted up, but hopefully you're having fun with this project as I am. Thanks so much for watching.
Now I get to wait and see, and look ridiculous, wearing colored things in hair. Whatever. It's not easy being green.
That's really attractive. Oh yeah.
Thanks a lot to be pity.
More like, takes a lot to work with curly hair and not have it look like a poodle.